Guys, this is Saurav, and you're watching the second part of the larynx. Before starting the lecture, I wanna recommend you to go and watch the first part of the larynx, because I'd explain the cartilage, joints, and the membrane in that lecture. So to get this lecture in a synchronized way, so go and watch that lecture too. So let's start with the muscles of the larynx. In this lecture, we will deal the muscles of the larynx. And we will deal mainly the intrinsic muscle, because extrinsic muscle can be read better way, like can be read in a better way in the pharynx, because all the extrinsic muscle is related to pharynx only, is not related to larynx. So before jumping in the muscles, I wanna explain you adenoid cartilage. Okay, so as you can see, guys, this cartilage is the arytenoid cartilage. It has processes. It has two processes: vocal process and the muscular process. This process, the process that is projecting inside the laryngeal cavity, that process is called the vocal process. Okay, and the process which is not projecting, which is outwards from the laryngeal cavity, and this process is called the muscular process. Because many muscles take attachments here, so this is called the muscular process. And guys, can you see this apex? Okay, this process, this part is called the apex. Okay, and if you can see this surface is called the medial surface. Okay, and if I will remove the thyroid cartilage, you can see this surface. Let me make it more clear. Okay, this surface is called the anterolateral surface, AL surface. So I hope the arytenoid cartilage is clear. Now we will jump into the muscles of the larynx, mainly the intrinsic muscle of the larynx. Okay guys, before jumping in the laryngeal muscle, the way I gonna teach is, first we will see the motion. Okay, what are the motion that is occurring or that can be occur in the larynx, and then we will go with the muscles. Okay, then we will show how that muscle is providing that type of motion. Okay, so guys, first you can see this portion is called the laryngeal inlet. Okay, like, so we have the muscle that will close the laryngeal inlet. Okay, and we have the muscle that will open the laryngeal inlet. Actually, opening of laryngeal inlet is somewhat elastic recoil. Okay, because as you can see, this hyoepiglottic ligament, provide the elastic recoil when the laryngeal inlet closes. Okay, so suppose this is the laryngeal inlet, when the epiglottis will come down and it will cover the larynx. Okay, the laryngeal inlet will close. So first you will see what are the muscles that causes the closing of the laryngeal inlet. So the first muscle that you can see is in the closing of the laryngeal inlet is the eryepiglottis muscle. Okay, so this is origin and this is insertion. So actually, according to book, the eryepiglottis muscle originate from the muscular process. It will be originating somewhat from the hair. So for better understanding, imagine it is originating from here. Okay, but insertion is correct. So what's gonna happen when this muscle will contract? What it will do? It will pull. Okay, it will pull the epiglottic flap. It will pull the epiglottic flap toward itself, and it will help in the closing of the laryngeal inlet. Well, I hope you understand these things. It is quite easy. Now the second muscle which causes the closing of the laryngeal inlet is this oblique muscle. दिस ओब्लिक एटनॉइड मसल एक्चुअली द पॉइंट वेयर द इंसर्शन ऑफ द ओब्लिक एरेटनॉइड अकर फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट द ओरिजिन ऑफ द एरीपिक्लॉटिस मसल अकर. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दीज टू थिंग्स दीज मसल आर सिंक्रोनाइज्ड. ओके सो द क्लोजिंग ऑफ द लैरिंजियल इनलेट विल एकोपनाई बाई ओब्लिक एटनॉइड ऑल्सो. सो दिस मसल ऑल्सो हेल्प इन द क्लोजिंग ऑफ द लैरिंजियल इनलेट. नाउ यू गोना आस्क हाउ इट हेल्प्स इन द क्लोजिंग ऑफ द लैरिंजियल इनलेट. सो सपोज 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 दिस इज हाउ द एरी एपिग्लॉटिस मसल इज अटैच. सो वेन आवर ओब्लीक मसल विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इट विल ब्रिंग द बोथ एरेटनॉइड कार्टिलेज क्लोजर. वेन इट ब्रिंग्स द बोथ एरेटनॉइड कार्टिलेज क्लोजर सो इट विल क्रिएट अ टेंशन इन द एरी एपिग्लॉटिस मसल टू इन समवट दिस मैकेनिज्म. बाई दिस मैकेनिज्म द एपिग्लॉटिक फ्लैप क्लोजेज द लैरिंग्स. ओके द इनलेट ऑफ लैरिंग्स इज क्लोज. नाउ वन मोर मसल that is called the thyroepiglottis muscle. Okay, actually this muscle is least explained in all the books, so I don't want to go much deep in that. Okay, so this muscle is called the thyroepiglottis muscle. THY thyroepiglottis muscle epiglottis muscle. What it does, see, actually someone says that this muscle help in the holding of the closed position, or someone says that it helps in the opening of the like laryngeal inlet. So this is quite controversial. So but as per our book suggests, the BDC and Visram Singh suggest this muscles helps in the opening of the laryngeal inlets. The next movement that we're gonna see is the abduction and adduction. So guys, what is abduction? Okay, so suppose this is your arachnoid cartilage. If you see from the superior view, it will somewhat look like L shape. Okay, this is L shape cartilage. Okay, so if this cartilage move like this, then it gonna opens the vocal cord. It gonna widen. Okay, it gonna widen this aperture. Okay, it gonna widen the aperture of the vocal cords. Okay, and the aperture will become widened. It will be get increase in diameter, and when it is get increase in diameter, you can breathe. Okay, so how the adenoid cartilage will look after the abduction? So it will look somewhat like diamond shape. It will look somewhat like this. So this is called the diamond shape. Now the thing is, what muscle causes the abduction of the vocal cord? So guys, there is only one muscle. Okay, there is only one muscle that causes the abduction of the vocal cord is the posterior cricoarytenoid. Okay, the posterior cricoarytenoid. Now we're gonna see how it does. Okay, so if you will isolate this, so guys, first of all, the insertion point of the posterior cricoarytenoid in this model is not correct. Okay, so we will modify it. We will see, actually the posterior cricoarytenoid is attached somewhat here. Okay, so suppose this is how the muscle fibers is there. So when it will contract, what it will do? When it will contract, it will pull the vocal cord in this direction. Okay, this attached like this. This pulling the vocal cord in this direction. So what's gonna happen? This aperture, okay, this aperture will become widened. Okay, posterior cricoarytenoid muscles is also called the safety muscle of larynx, because it opens the, it widens the aperture, laryngeal aperture, and it help in the inspiration. Okay guys, the next movement that we're gonna see is the adduction. So how does adduction occur and what is adduction? So as you can see, this is our L-shaped cartilage. So when the cartilage is moving inwards, so this causes adduction. So after adduction, how the cartilage will look? Because after abduction, the cartilage was looking like a diamond shape. So but after adduction, the cartilage will look somewhat like this. Okay, so why I am mentioning the shape? Because mentioning the shape is important for phonation. Okay, as I said that this lecture, the muscles, the movement and the phonation, all these things are connected. So we'll see these three things in a synchronized way. So guys, let's see what muscles causes the adduction. So the muscle called lateral cricoretinoid, C-R-I-C-O, cricoretinoid, this muscle causes the adduction. Now how it causes, we will see. Get isolated. So guys, can you see? See, for this muscle, the insertion is somewhat correct, but not totally correct. So what gonna happen, it will be inserted, is inserted somewhat here. So what will happen when the lateral cricoretinoid, okay, it contracts, what it does, it will pull the cartilage like this. Okay, it will pull the cartilage like this and it causes the adduction. So what happens while adduction, the aperture, okay, while adduction, this aperture gets shrunken. Okay, this aperture is getting smaller, the diameter of the aperture is getting smaller, and one more muscle that cause the adduction is the transverse retinoid. So actually, this is very simple. What this muscle will do, this muscle will simply contract and it will bring the two retinoid closer. Okay, and if it is bringing the two retinoid closer, automatically it is closing the aperture, it is narrowing the aperture. Okay, so this is how the abduction and adduction of vocal cords occur. Now we will see the muscle that increases the tension and the muscle which decreases the tension in the vocal cord. So guys, vocal cord refers to the muscle vocalis plus ligament. So how the things gonna occur? Suppose this is your vocal fold, true vocal fold. Now anything that will decrease this diameter, this length, anything that will decrease this length will decrease the tension of the muscles of the vocal cords. That will decrease the tension of the vocal cord. Anything that decrease this length, this diameter, will decrease the tension. So you can imagine that you have a rope, okay, and the both rope are like attached to the two points, and if you will bring that two point closer, the tension in the rope will decreases. Okay, and whatever movement that will take that two point away, that will separate the two point, those motion will increase the tension, because we are stretching the rope. This is how the things gonna run. Okay, so whatever muscle is decreasing the diameter, is bringing the two point near, that muscle will decrease the tension. Okay, and the muscle which is increasing the length, increasing the distance between two point, that muscle will increase the tension. So we're gonna see what are the muscle. So the first muscle that decreases the tension is the thyroarytenoid. So let's see where is our thyroarytenoid. So this is our thyroarytenoid. So when this muscle will contract, when this thyroarytenoid will contract, what it will do, it will decrease this distance, okay, and bring the origin and insertion point of the vocal cord closer. Because of that, it decreases the tension. Okay. Now the second thing is that what are the muscle that increases the tension? So guys, before I said that, I think in the last lecture I said that this muscle, the cricothyroid muscle, what it does when this muscle contracts, it pulls the cartilage, it's pulled the thyroid cartilage forward and downward, because this is oblique muscle. So as you can see, man, if something is oblique, it has two direction like this. So it will pull the cartilage, thyroid cartilage forward and downward. So because of this pulling, suppose this is at its place, and you had pull the thyroid cartilage, so the tension will increase because the origin and insertion point are getting stretched. Okay, they are pulled apart. Okay, so the tension will increase. These are the motions and the phenomena of the muscles, of the intrinsic muscle of the vocal cord. Now we will see the different shapes of the larynx while different positions of the phonation. Okay, or different types of sound, we will see the different shape. So as you can see, this shape is while we are in the quiet respiration. Okay, the inlet will open, not fully open, half open, partially open, and we are doing the quiet respiration the way we do all the time. Okay, guys, before going in this, I want to tell you one thing. When we exhale, while exhaling, we create sound. Okay, when we inhale, okay, we don't create much sound. Okay, the sound is not created, the voice is not created while inhaling. Okay, the sound is created while exhaling. This position, this is called the diamond shape position. As I said, that when the adenoid cartilage will abducted, okay, at that point you will see the diamond shape position, and that position is during inspiration, not quite inspiration, during inspiration, full inspiration, you can say, like with full force when we are inspiring. So we need aperture to be more widened. Okay, the aperture should be widened, the vocal cord should be abducted. Okay, so because of that, while forceful inspiration, we have the diamond shape. Okay, now this shape. Okay, this shape is during high pitch. Guys, I want to explain here what is pitch and how the pitch is related to the length of the vocal cord. Okay, so suppose this is your thyroid cartilage, thyroid insertion point, and this is your adenoid point. So this is our vocal cord. So when the length will increase, the vocal cord will get tensed, and when the vocal cord is get tense, and as the law of physics said, whenever something is tense and you put vibration, you give some vibrating energy at that tense thing, okay, it will vibrate with high frequency. So whenever the tension is increases, the frequency will be high. Okay, so note all these things. Tension for high frequency, high tension for high frequency, low tension for low frequency. Okay, so now this shape, this shape is called the funnel shape. Okay, this shape is called the funnel shape. This is when we are whispering. Okay, when we are talking very, extremely slowly, at that time we will have the whispering. Okay, so at this shape we have the funnel shape. Okay, I said now, while adduction, the adenoid cartilage become funnel shape. So this is how the funnel shape look. See, while abduction, the cartilage will become diamond shape. But while adduction, the cartilage will become funnel shape. I think I had taught everything. Okay. In the next lecture, we will see some clinicals with some of the cadaveric images and the nerve supply and the blood supply of the larynx. Okay, thank you guys. This is Saurav signing out. If you like this video, do subscribe my channel. share with your friend and like it. Thank you.